As we saw in episode 3, the platform uses the ref standard attribute as an internal object identifier. This is how the platform tells one object from another. But sometimes we humans need to identify objects too. For example, any accountable document must have a unique number, so that people are always sure they talk about the same document. Another example is person's initials or a short nickname that can be easier to refer to instead of something like Konstantin Rupasov or Zachary Galifianakis. This is what we use code and number standard attributes for. The code attribute lives in the catalogs. And the number attribute lives in the documents. As you will see, these two attributes are only named differently, but work essentially the same. You can specify the catalog's code and the document's number manually. But we use it for identification, so it has to be unique to some extent, right? This is why it's usually assigned automatically. It's all set up here on the numbering tab. And there are our autonumbering checkboxes. You can also ask the platform to make sure that all codes or numbers are unique using these checkboxes. Even when the autonumbering is on, you still can set the code or number manually. But the platform will ask you to think twice before doing that. Both code and number can be a string or a number. This is how it's set up for the catalogs. And this is for the documents. The difference will be that the string code number will be padded by leading zeros like this. Another difference with the string type attribute is that we can add a prefix to it. This is done right here in the metadata object module. Here is the onSetNewNumber event, and its handler has the prefix parameter. I can set it to any string, and these are the document numbers I'll start getting. It works the same for the catalogs, but the event is called onSetNewCode. This prefix thing opens up some interesting prospects numbering-wise. For example, I can maintain several independent number sequences within one metadata object. I might not want my purchase documents to be numbered continuously. If these two documents belong to the Infinity Foods supplier and this one belongs to the Gross Grocery, then I really should expect questions like, is this our first document and why its number is 2 then? Or, excuse me, did we lose our second document somewhere because we have number 3 following number 1? So I want my purchase documents to be numbered separately, depending on the supplier. And this is how we do that using prefixes. First of all, I need to bind the purchase documents with my company's catalog like this. Then I will create a new attribute named prefix here in the company's catalog. And now I'm going to the purchase documents metadata object module, creating the onSetNewNumber event handler and writing this simple code. Set the prefix to this object, which is the current purchase document, dot our new company attribute, dot and our new prefix attribute of the company's catalog. Okay, let's try it. First, I go to the company's catalog and assign the prefix for the Infinity Foods company. Then I create a new company and give it another prefix. Now I'm creating a purchase document with Infinity Foods. And here we go, the document with IFD prefix is here. The second one with the same company. And the document number is increased by 1. Okay, let's try the Gross Grocery supplier. First document, and we have another number 1 document with a different prefix. the second one, and the number is now 2. So I have an independent numbering for each prefix. Great! Wait, what happens if I use the same prefix for another company? Well, let's try. I'm going to create a test company and give it the same prefix as my Infinity Foods has. And now, if I create a purchase document with this test company, I'll have the document number 3. So, what the platform does, it just remembers all the prefixes and tracks the number sequences inside each one of them. If it sees the same prefix, it just uses this prefix sequence, that's it. So, we can use the prefixes and just a tiny bit of coding to split the number and sequence of a single metadata object. Platform also supports some other fully automatic ways of splitting the numbering. For the catalogs, this feature is called Code Series, and it works along with the hierarchies we were talking about in the last episode. Remember these two standard attributes? If I select this option, the numbering will be split between parents. There will be one independent sequence of codes within each group, or within each item if it's the item-item hierarchy. If I select this option, the same will happen to the ownership hierarchy. Each owner will have its own independent sequence of codes. There is some numbering sequence splitting for the documents too. It's called periodicity and it's built around the document's date. The idea here is that we might want to reset the document number once in a while. You know, start a new life from Monday and celebrate it by starting over all document counters. On a serious note, there might be official requirements about resetting numbers of unaccountable documents, so these are our options. We can reset the counter and start the numbering over at the beginning of a year, a quarter, a month, or a day. This was splitting the numbering sequences within one metadata object. Sometimes, reasonably rare, we need the opposite, to keep the single sequence of numbering across several documents. It might be necessary, for example, for somewhat similar documents that belong to the different metadata objects. In this case, we use document numerators that live right here. We can set up these already familiar properties for a numerator and then use it in as many documents as we need. Just like this. So, these are our numbering options. Stay tuned for the next episode about predefined data.